Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Gigabyte Challenge. I know we had a bit of a break. We were waiting for the teams to get in, as well as me switching studios. Oh, back to where I belong, baby. It's exactly what I want to see. We actually have to, we're going to go ahead. We're going to get straight into the draft right now because we're actually a little underway. So enough with the intros real quick. We got a game to cast. We got a really important game to cast. Team Dog is going to be facing up against 4FC. That's right. Krilly is back, and he's got a whole new crew that's going to be joining him. And while we talk about this, the heroes that are being picked up right now, go ahead and welcome in my co-caster. He's going to be joining me for the first time. And I know a lot of you guys love him. I love all the effort he puts into his cast. Coddle Guy is going to be joining me on the mic today.
What's up, Capitalist? How's it going? Can you hear me coming in loud and clear?
Yeah, you're actually, you're sounding pretty good, despite the fact that, Skype keeps telling me that we've got connection problems. You sound great. You sound perfect.
Fantastic. Well, I'm happy to be here, Cap. I appreciate it. I'm very humbled that you will let me join you as a co-caster, and we both got to see Team Dog actually unmercifully destroy.
And there it goes. There it goes. Coddle Guy, you still there, buddy?
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Okay. No. Yeah, you just cut out for, you just like randomly just like whoop, cut out. But yes, you were talking about how Team Dog pretty much left no mercy to hashtag ban Earth in round one.
Big fans of Banner Spirit. I got to watch them through the Helios tournament stuff. So they definitely have a lot of talent, but I don't know if it was just more of a matter of draft or just getting outclassed, but man, Dog has been on a tear. They beat Liquid before they even got to that one, so.
Damn it. Damn it all the hell. All right, sorry, guys. I really was hoping to be able to bring Coddle Guy in because he is a very, very entertaining caster. He's been doing a lot of good work on the community channel, and I tore him away from his stream, too. I was like, hey, you want to come co-cast and everything, and now it looks like, damn it. It just looks like, you know, crossing over the Atlantic is really not going to work for us. So, I'm sorry, Coddle Guy. Thanks, man, for coming on. I do appreciate it. You've been awesome. Unfortunately, it just doesn't look like our connection's going to work out. So, let's talk about the game, guys. We got a lot of draft to get underway now. 4FC, apparently they were paying attention to Team Dog earlier. They go ahead and ban away the Centaur as well as the Naga Siren, so no Naga mid is going to be seen this time around. Team Dog, though, they ban away the Lycan as well as the Nyx Assassin. We have the Invoker and Visage grabbed up by Team Dog, so no Batrider for them. It's going to be in the hands of 4FC, who also grab a Chen. So initiation mixed with push. Look for a mid-game-oriented draft that involves a little bit extra push off of that. 4FC, they go ahead and ban away the Clockwork as well as the Bounty Hunter, taking away some of those potent offlaners. However, Team Dog are still going to be able to find the Fury in their hands, while Spectre is also going to go their way, so they do have that carry now. Hard carry Naga Spectre with an Invoker backing him up. Pretty damn good mid to late game, as well as you've got a Furion. This late game is pretty much unstoppable, as it looks like. Team Dog, they banned away the Alchemist as well as the Luna. So they take those two out, taking away some of the Alchemists. Very, very interesting pickup. Maybe they know a little bit more about 4FC than I gave them credit for, because I have not seen a whole lot of Alchemists of late. But maybe they ran that in round one. We're going to see 4FC, though. They pick up the Dazzle, so good defensive support that is going to be able to help their carry Gyrocopter live through any sort of you know, Sunstrikes, Furion Ultimate, any sort of nukes coming the way of the Gyrocopter fairly early on. This Dazzle is going to be able to keep him alive with both his heal and his Shallow Wave. So, Gyrocopter now has a little bit extra tank with the supports backing him up of both the Dazzle and the Chen. You've got the good initiation of the Batrider being able to pull in some enemy heroes and allow Gyrocopter to just get off that good ultimate as well as that flat cannon shots that devastate a lot of teams. Crystal Main is going to be the last pick coming out from Team Dog, who also ban away the Puck. No surprise there. We need some good initiation here for 4FC, and they are going to find it in a Storm Spirit last pick. So, no matter what, they're still able to find some good initiation and also gives them a little bit better mid to late game. However, this lineup is entirely going to depend on snowballing for 4FC. I mean, you're looking at this Storm Spirit. If he can pick up a fast Orchid, he's going to be shutting down the Nature's Prophet. He's going to be able to jump in on the Invoker, maybe even pick off the Spectre a few times, who may be a little bit tankier than those other two, but still is rather easily caught out. So Storm Spirit can get in an early lead in his laning phase. He's going to be looking damn good to just kind of like snowball and continually shut down Team Dog while the Gyrocopter gets nice and big and ready to end the game. Meanwhile, Team Dog, though, they've got a good amount of late game and should be able to rather easily take this if as long as they can push it past the 30-minute mark. That's when Furion and the Spectre are really going to be coming online. MSS, he's going to be on the Invoker instead. So the switch up that we saw last game with PyCat playing the middle Naga Siren, he was playing it more like a hard carry, and it looks like MSS is going to go back to that middle lane now that he's going to be playing the Invoker. So starting this off, though, real quick, 4FC, let's talk about who's playing what. On the 4FC side, we got Carl Phillip, because we got some new names to talk about for this 4FC team, so definitely want to give these some of these guys a shout-out. Carl Phillip, he's going to be on the Gyrocopter. Juicy, or Juicy? We're going to call him Juicy. I like that name a little bit better. Dazzle, he's going to be playing that. Slum Bomb is going to be on the Chen. We have good old Krilly. He's going to be on the Batrider. Excellent offlaner. Always love watching him play, especially if he can get Lone Druid into his hands. Very, very strong offlane player. And middle, we have Eris Loco, which I've seen a couple times before. Probably playing for 4FC in the past. So you got a couple of new names, got a couple of old names, and good old Team Dog, though. Mainly old names here. So we're going to see PyCat, Fogged, Misery, MSS, and Smuggling. No Demon anymore for Team Dog. Really, right now, he's setting up on the rune, but Fog's just going to chase him away. So going back to this lineup, we got a defensive tri-lane going on here with the Crystal main. Looks like she's going to be kind of full-time jungling for this first couple of levels. Look for a smoke as soon as these heroes hit level 2 or 3. They're going to be able to smoke up, maybe try and shut down the Storm Spirit fairly early on. But also, Chen can do the same. Now, he doesn't really have the best supporting duo here with the Dazzle. I mean, if you could get level 2 Poison Touch, it's decent ability to be able to roam into the mid lane and slow down a hero, but not as strong as many other supports. So not going to be the greatest in the world. I do put a ganking advantage for Team Dog. However, the Crystal main not going to be able to farm up quite as fast as this Chen, and that is going to be a big advantage for 4FC. Also being able to turn that farming advantage into some early towers and move on from there. Real quick, I just want to check on... All right, cool. Just wanted to be able to check in on the chat, see if there's anything going on, make sure that we are all good and set up. Eris Loco take a little bit of harassment here from MSS. We take a look at the creep score. He was doing fine in CS, just losing a lot of his life. And is going to have to pop some of those early tangos, but should have a bottle on the way and up to him in the next 30 seconds. So he'll be able to survive. MSS is just trying to put in that early advantage that he has. And a very, very smart play at that. Krilly, he's forced out continually by Misery. Grave Chill, really, really good ability in harassing out offlaners. Slows them down, gives you that extra attack speed, so you can get a lot of auto attacks. Is actually very, very strong at being able to harass out enemy heroes, and it's got cheap mana cost, so why not? You gotta love it. And you can already see Crystal Main Fogged was earlier. He was doing the hard camp. You already can already see he's cleaned up two of these bigger creeps and is going to be stacking it with a bunch of smaller creeps and eventually clear through them. But a smoke up, a solo smoke is going to be found by Fogged as he may run into Slum Bomb here. Hold up, sitting on the 2-minute rune. Both the supports, well, Chen just lost eyes on it. But now he turns around, sees it's not there, and Crystal Main does the same. And we're going to see... See Fogged, see if he can try and possibly gank up Eris Loco here fairly early on, or maybe even catch out the courier might have been one of his thoughts. However, the bottle is already here for Eris Loco, so it's going to be primarily trying to get this gank off. Now, Fogged does have level 2, but chose to went for that second level into Arcane Aura rather than the extra ganking power from Crystal Nova. Not a terrible surprise here. Oh, early EMP. This is a smart play from MSS. He's going to be able to burn away some of that extra mana from Eris Loco and force out Bottle Crowing really, really early on. I mean, he needs to Bottle Crow already, and it's not even 3 minutes in. Not really a good sign. However, Eris Loco still picking up a decent amount of CS in this lane. So, again, taking a lot of harassment, but still grabbing those creeps. PyCat, he's free farming, no surprise. 11-5 on him, while the Gyrocopter right now is 9-1. So, falling a little bit farther behind, but... Still, the lane is pushed out. He's been forced to last hit under tower a little bit times. And Juicy, actually, very, very sad. This hard camp was not up. So he had nothing to be able to pull, meaning this lane is going to push out, and Furion's going to be pretty happy about that one until he realizes that he's got a gank coming in from behind. The attempt at a teleport not going to go down in time. It's a good play from Juicy there, using that Shadow Wave. I'm pretty sure they would have killed him before he got the teleport off anyway, but that Shadow Wave just blew him up there. Two different targets. That's 160 damage going the way of that Furion, thanks to the Hellbear Smasher being right up close to him. So gets blown up, and Furion still actually going to come in from behind, looking to be able to gank up Aeris Loco, who's being held up by Cold Snap, and with no mana, cannot defend himself in any way, and will go down. Krilly, he's going to make a rotation as well and chase down the other offlaner, but he's just not going to get there in time. MSS very, very low after diving that tower, but has that Quas build to be able to get back some of that regen, and I'm sure he's got a little bit extra coming his way. There it is, a healing salve as well as boots. Phase boots are going to be up for him, so now he's got, after that kill, a huge advantage in this middle lane. He's going to be able to really put a lot of pressure on this Storm Spirit pre-level 6, which is exactly what you want to see. Fogged, he's holding up the Chen creep that is currently drawing the aggro. And now he's going to pull the creeps off of the tower, but it's not going to matter. His tier 1 tower is still going to fall. And 4FC, that's that Chen advantage coming into play. They take an early gold lead, or at least should off of that. There it is, dips down to almost 1,000 gold lead off of that one tower going down. However, so much of this lineup is going to be dependent on the Storm Spirit, and he's already having a very, very hard time going up against MSS, and this gets even worse. Now that you've got a good Tornado EMP combo up, you've got the ability to, he's got enough mana to throw down a Cold Snap after that, and the movement speed to be able to keep up with the Storm Spirit and get in as many auto attacks as possible. There it is, Tornado EMP, Cold Snap, and look at the follow-up. Furion, he's even trying to come in. Shallow Grave should be able to keep Aeris Loco alive, however, not even needing it, as Gyrocopter actually does pick up Smogleek at top, who was going to teleport and then chose not to. He chose not to teleport mid, maybe hoping to just keep this tier 2 alive, however, still gets caught out by the Gyrocopter. There was no missile. Like, the only reason that Smogleek should really die there is because of the missile. However, he's got no level of missile to interrupt that teleport, so I'm not really sure why. Bottom, though, Krilly, oh no, he's got nowhere to go. Pycat, thanks to this Spectral Dagger, was able to follow him no matter where he went. Spectre, really good point here. The fact that really, really good against the offlane is better against the offlane Batrider than Spectre normally is against offlaners. The dagger is not really great. It's got a very, very low movement speed change and is not, she's not really able to output a whole lot of damage unless you get in a lot of solid disables. Most offlaners have no problem with a Spectre carry. However, Batrider has some issues because he just tries to go off the cliff and Spectre will just follow you to the ends of the earth. So that's actually a slight problem. Aeris Loco, he's finally picked up his level 6, but he still has to worry about this Tornado EMP combo, because with the Cold Snap follow-up, it's very conceivable that thanks to EMP's buff, you easily are able to get that off on the Storm Spirit, even if he does try and zip away. Salam Bomb, interesting. Looks like he's going to be going for Arcane Boots. Is stacked up 1,000 gold for it. So he's going to grab that. Arcane Boots, always welcome when you're dealing with a Quas Wex Invoker. That Tornado EMP combo just can be so crippling. So if you have some mana boots to be able to regain some of that mana lost, it's really, really helpful. Top, though, we actually have Gyrocopter, who's going to try and teleport away here. Not going to be... Oh, wow! They actually were able to do enough damage there. Pycat was somehow able to get off a big Desolate hit there that killed Gyrocopter inside the base. Inside the base. MSS, meanwhile, he found a kill on Battle. Dazzle's gone down. Slam Bomb, he's going to follow him to the grave. As making a little bit of a juking maneuver, MSS, thanks to the fact that it's nighttime, does not see Slam Bomb right now. However, really? Slam Bomb's going to live. MSS, I don't think he's going to check here. And there it is. Slam Bomb makes his retreat. So, hey, what a juke. I can't say I've ever seen that spot actually work when you're trying to run away and juke people. Mainly because, like, it's so isolated, right? But, hey, it was nighttime. Easy to lose track of those enemy heroes. And maybe MSS just kind of assumed that he tucked into maybe one of, like, this hiding hole and teleported away or something. Double damage going to be found for Aeris Loco. Big rune pickup because they really need to shut down this Spectre, who currently has phase boots as well as a robot Magi. Look for a drums pickup. So some early stat items are going to be up on the Spectre. 40 and 10 right now when it comes to CS. But let's take a look at that net worth since we do have some towers going down. Top three net worth all on the board going the way of Team Dog right now. Gyrocopter, he's beginning to rival some of that. But it's still a very, very bad sign right now for 4FC that both their middle and their offlaner are so damn far behind. But we'll just have to keep our eyes on Aeris Loco and what kind of rotation he makes. Krilly, really far behind right now. Due to the fact that he picked up a bottle, he is nowhere close to that blink dagger. That's going to be a big issue in about that 15-minute mark when you want to be able to see the Storm Spirit and the Batrider move around picking off these enemy heroes. And they're not going to be able to because they just won't have the items. Orchid is never going to be up for Storm Spirit anytime soon. And that blink dagger, again, very, very delayed. Tier 1 tower. Krilly, he's going to attempt to deny it here and won't get it. Tornado is going to interrupt him. EMP goes off as well. And MSS successfully with his extra bit of damage from phase boots claims the tier 1 tower kill. Midas is now up for Smogalik, so he may have went down fairly early on in his offlane, but he's made one hell of a recovery, being a part of multiple kills. Smoke up, we're actually going to see 4FC. I think this is the right maneuver. Right now, just kind of like group up and go for pickoffs. They got to shut down the Spectre before she gets a little too hard to kill. Once you have drums, you got the movement speed and enough tank to be able to survive through a lot. Piecat, though, getting caught out by four heroes. You're not getting away from that one, friend. So all five heroes for 4FC are now bottom. MSS backs them up with a good EMP. And looks like Slum Bomb actually still going for the mech. I was kind of agreeing with the Arcane Boots choice that I thought he was going to be going for. However, thinks twice about it. Hopefully he's still going to be able to get off that mech because one EMP is going to burn away all mana. Not only mech, but also his ultimate, Hand of God. Not going to be there for a lot of these team fights if MSS is landing good Tornado EMP combos. So that's going to be quite the issue. Krilly, he's in some trouble. Ultimate, double global ultimates going down. That's the power of this strategy with the Furion and the Spectre. You have the Spectre to be able to reveal everyone. And pretty much guaranteeing that the Furion ult is going to be able to hit everyone. Unless there's an excessive number of units on Invision, chances are you will hit every single hero. And that Spectre ultimate already doing a decent amount thanks to almost maxed out Desolate already, Piecat. Next level, he's going to be hitting for an extra 65 damage a hit. That's the power of a Spectre. It's no longer the old Spectre of days where it was maxed out dispersion and you just went like kind of tanky with Radiance and just soaked up damage. Now we're actually seeing Spectre be a lot more aggressive going into the early to mid game where Desolate just destroys enemy heroes. Already, we have a medallion up for Misery. He's pretty damn farmed right now for a support hero. 2,800 gold. He is above Krilly right now, who was really, really struggling to get that blink dagger. One hero who's not doing too terrible on 4FC has got to be Carl Philip, his gyrocopter. Treads, Helm of Dominator, look for a stacking. Bottom though, Batrider looking for a pickoff, but the invis grabbed by Misery in time. Middle, Juicy right now is just trying to protect the tier 1 tower, but everywhere you look, Dog is picking up a lot more out of the map. We have 4FC playing very, very scared in all of their lanes, except for this top one, where Gyrocopter has very, very little to fear. He sees all these heroes in middle. They're going to go for the tier 1 tower. Teleports in, though, and with the glyph, they might be able to turn this. EMP going to go down. Aeris Loco zips in, zips back out to dodge the EMP. Fogged, he's going to get caught out. Bounced out, though, by the Batrider nuke. MSS, he's going to go down. No, good force staff is going to be able to save him. Aeris Loco on the pursuit, but the minions come down. Familiars lock him in place. Aeris Loco, there goes that Spectre ultimate. See if he can clean up this Storm Spirit. No, Juicy, actually. Heals him up at just the perfect time, and Krilly stays alive through the extra nuke. So an Invoker in exchange for a Chen. Not a bad exchange whatsoever. And they also get the denied tower. Really great team fight for 4FC. Granted, they're still playing from behind, but little plays like that, just making sure that Team Dog don't really overly snowball so early on. Jesus, every single time I look at Krilly right now, I'm just like, how long until Blink Dagger? It seems to be forever. Right now, Chen's going to send him back as Smuggleig with just Phase Boots. Was auto-attacking him down. Looks like we're going to see a Necronomicon build coming out from the Furion. And no surprise, you want to be able to see, you don't want to see a combative build here if you have a stronger late game. Just go for a little bit of split push on this Furion. Go for Necronomicon. Rat your way to 30, 35 minutes in. And Spectre will do the rest of the work. You get bigger on the Furion, the Invoker. Hell, even the Visage will be able to benefit from the game going later and later, as Familiar's always very, very strong and already on the way to his Aghanim's. So he's looking pretty damn good. Right now, Slam Bomb, he's going to run into MSS. MSS gets aggressive, throws down the Tornado, misses, though. And they're just going to go ahead and turn this on the Centaur, though. Juicy, he's actually going to get aggressive here. Holding in, Fog, getting taken down from a distance here as Carphillip throws down that ultimate and cleans them up. So MSS baits his support ally into a bad position there, and Fog just doesn't back up in time. Aris Loco, meanwhile, he's got Oblivion Staff and another 800 gold, so he's getting there, but you really want to see that before 20 minutes. Aris Loco fighting up against PyCat, but just one auto attack does so much more than Storm Spirit. So he's got to run away. Necronomicon soon going to be online for the Furion. And let's take a look at that gold lead. 4,000 gold lead right now for Team Dog. Experience dipped down quite a bit in the favor of 4FC. After they got a couple of pickoffs, that's great, but still. It's still a big issue right now that 4FC, they're playing from behind and they've got a better mid-game lineup that they need to be able to control these laning phase. That way they can start snowballing early and have enough power to be able to take Rax before the Spectre gets too big. Four-man smoke, and they're going to go into the enemy jungle here. They're going to spy out Fog. That's going to be a quick kill. But the question is, can they go for more here? Aris Loco already positioning himself to grab more here. Has Misery locked up, and that's going to be two kills from that one gank, but maybe the turnaround. MSS looking for it. Oh, great familiar stuns into the tornado. EMP, these heroes going to be feeling the burn now. Hand to God protects him a little bit, but Juicy's still going to fall. Slam Bomb, maybe he can get away, though. Krilly is providing a little bit of interference with that sticky napalm, but just the straight-up auto attacks plus the dagger. Too strong. And now Krilly may even go down. Look at that desolate damage. Just doing so much work, and they may have lost two heroes, but they just chased down 4FC, who completely blew their load early and decided to just run away after those two supports instead of just trying to turn and fight. I mean, these heroes are not the tankiest right now. I think they could have turned and fought back Team Dog instead of just letting hero after hero get picked off. Either way, though, Smuggleite's going to be happy with that turn of events. Picking up a little bit of extra gold for him. MSS, how you doing? He's got a 4 stat plus another 1,000 gold. And anything on the courier? Nope. I love this aggressive vision coming out from Team Dog. With the Furion Spectre, jungle vision is really, really strong. Because you're able to get vision of some of those heroes that are isolated. First of all, they're isolated. But second of all, they might be a little bit low from jungling up. They're not really expecting a gank to be coming their way. And so if you're able to see them half health, farming up, go ahead, throw down the Furion ultimate and the Spectre. And you're going to do a lot of work here. Right now, Fog, very, very smart game sense here, but it's not going to be enough. As he threw down a ward, but it immediately gets countered by Juicy. And this stack is still going to go down. Aris Loco, though, looking for Fog, not going to be able to find him. Ultimate's going to go off. Looks like they may go for Carl Philip. Top, though, Slum Bomb, possibly. No, Spectre straight up doesn't go for any of those. PyCat chooses to not jump in anywhere. Gyrocopter and Dazzle, they were comboed up. Aris Loco was nearby. That was probably not a good idea to jump bottom, but I thought he might have gone for the Chen, seeing as he was slightly isolated in the jungle. Really very, very low here. That's a rather bold move when you got Furion. Granted, the Spectre ultimate is down, sure, absolutely, but You still got to deal with a Furion. If they have any vision right now of Creely, he's going to die. They don't even need the Furion ultimate. Just a straight up teleport, summon Necronomicon minions, chase him down. So Creely, desperately, he's playing risky right now, but he knows how badly he needs this Blink Dagger. So he will be able to pick it up here real soon. Couple more auto attacks, and he's got it. So even if he dies now, he'll still be able to have the Blink Dagger when he revives. So good job by him making a recovery, picking it up before the 20-minute mark. It's not great, but it could have been a lot worse with the way this game was going. Right now, Carl Phillip, he does finish up his BKB. So look for 4FC to probably start grouping up here pretty soon. As soon as they have the mech, they've got the Blink. If they could have Orchid up on the Storm, those are all big items that are necessary for the mid-game of 4FC. So they can finish off those last couple items. I think that you're going to be looking for a lot of action from 4FC. Meanwhile, Team Dog probably just going to wrap their way in. Don't really need to fight a whole lot, especially when you've got a Radiance coming in for Pycat. Go ahead, sit back, farm up, split push as much as humanly possible. Necronomicon 3 is going to be up now for Smuggling. 20 minutes in, a Necro Book 3 is rather devastating. Whether it's in split pushing or team fights, it is still going to absolutely destroy 4FC. One good thing is Gyrocopter, he can fight up against a melee Necronomicon minion and pop it thanks to the BKB without too much worries. But his other allies, not so lucky. Mech is now finished up by the Chen, so our last item pickup, Orchid, that's up too. Really expecting Team Dog to get, not Team Dog, 4FC to really get aggressive now. Scythe of Ice is going to be the next picked up for MSS. Halfway to our Aghanim's up on Misery, so he's doing pretty damn good. Tornado, EMP. Gyrocopter, he doesn't want to use his early BKB. However, every single time that happens, he has to kind of consider it because look how low he got just from the Invoker. He's below half health. If you were to be hit by that Furion ultimate before you were able to pick off the BKB, before you were able to use the BKB, you get hit by the Furion ultimate, you take a little bit more damage, and then you have the Spectre coming in as well, just throwing down a dagger for the extra movement speed and chasing you down. Gyrocopter is not that tanky. He relies very, very heavily on his BKB. He may even want to build into, you don't really want to pick up another small stat item, but Helm of Dominator, Ring of Aquila, that might not be enough. You almost need to be able to pick up a Drums, just one of those situations where a small item now might make the difference, whereas a larger item later, I feel like it's just not going to be able to come online early enough. So if you have just that little bit of extra tank, that might win you the team fight. So I would almost kind of love to see Drums up for the Gyrocopter as his next item, as he almost has it straight up. Eris Logo, he's going to be able to find Misery here thanks to Krilly's pickoff. Still the turnaround. Krilly's going to go down here. Misery's still going to fall, but Eris Logo takes a lot of damage too. Cold Snap going down. Hand to God is going to be able to keep Storm Spirit up a little bit longer, but they're still chasing him down. Thanks to Fog being able to slow him up, they will pick up the kill, and now Pycat is dominating. Who cares about the tier 1 tower going down? It was probably going to go down anyway. You're still split pushing, you're still making some sort of trade, and you just picked up another kill for Pycat, who now has the Radiance on its way. And next ultimate is going to be pretty damn deadly for 4FC. So I really think they need to be able to take a lot more. Take this last tier 1 tower, turn it into a push into the tier 2. Just gotta hope that your team fight can win it for you before the Spectre ultimate is up. Smogly, good block off there with the Sprout. Just to make sure he's gonna be fine. Juicy's actually gonna be found here. No nukes are gonna come out in time though as he teleports away. Slum Bomb, let's see if he gets Arcane's Tornado. Just kinda rambling on through. So Gyrocopter, he goes for the big item, has the Demon Edge already up. If he can farm up that MKB in time, it's going to be hitting pretty decently hard. And they might just be able to turn and fight the Spectre when he comes into those team fights. However, once Pycat starts building into a little extra tank, hell, just a naked bit attack booster would do a lot for you on the Spectre right now, thanks to the high levels of dispersion. Every bit amount of health that you get right now is worth its weight in gold. MSS, he's going to get caught out here. Oris Loco does just charge in. As Aura could go down, now they're going to hold him up as well. Gyrocopter holding in. Now going to be able to clean up MSS as well as the Necronomicon minion. So that's a good amount of gold going their way. Smoglake, he does teleport away in time. Misery is going to be fine, though, as he walks out. Good fight. That's exactly what 4FC needed there. They either forced a good team fight or they forced a good pickoff. Either way, they're going to be happy with what happened in that bottom lane, and they're going to turn it into a tier 1 tower. Misery getting aggressive. Oh, the buyback from MSS. He's now going to get aggressive now. Send back. Krilly might just get out in time. No, he still goes down. Slam Bomb going to fall down as well. Juicy attempts the teleport away. No stuns are going to be able to come out. Very, very smart play. However, Smuggly does find Storm Spirit in the back and with no mana to be able to leap away. Easily kills them. So as soon as they saw the gyrocopter go top, immediately the buyback and force the team fight bottom. Well worth it. As MSS got his gold back thanks to some assists. Pycat looking really, really big now. And there it is, the naked vit booster. Sells his stout shield in exchange for just a little bit of extra tank, and now going to turn this into Roshan. So good things going the way of Team Dog. Let's take a look at that gold lead. Growing, growing, growing. 7,500 and almost a 7,500 experience lead as well. Things looking not good, and I've said this before, I am not a Divine Rapier mongerer, but you almost kind of hope the Gyro goes for a Divine Rapier right now because they're just so far behind. You got to go for something drastic here. You got to go risky. Roshan getting very, very low, but all of 4FC are aware of what's going down, and they make the rotation in. And Team Dog forced back for now, but you know they're not going to give Roshan up entirely. Spectre ultimate up in just another 30 seconds. They're going to try and keep tabs, though. You can already see the Furion Treants are holding on inside of the pit. They can't afford to give up Roshan to Gyrocopter. That is just a no-go right now. They need to be able to chase away 4FC. Don't think they should really go for the team fight right now. Just wait on Spectre's ultimate, which is actually almost up. Yeah. He's going to go start the split pushing. This is what I want to see. They're going to try and delay 4FC as much as humanly possible. And when 4FC commit to taking Roshan, that's when you're going to see the initiation coming out from the Spectre and the follow up with a Furion ultimate. That by itself is going to bring so many heroes very, very low. Six, one, and five. Pycat is huge right now. And when he has a heart, there's pretty much nothing stopping him. Look at him constantly keeping tabs of what's going on inside the Roche pit, but it's getting very, very low. And here comes the initiation. Small EMP being thrown down. There goes the ult from Spectre. Look at him. Already very, very low. And they're fighting up Spectre, trying to think about Gyrocopter. He's getting off that full flat cannon damage, though, but it doesn't seem to care. All of Team Dog are doing great. Now Misery. He is able to pick up the Dazzle. Carl Phil fighting up against Pycat. They will be able to pop him, but trades his own life in exchange for it. And a lot of damage going down. Ares Loco. No more jumps. Small leap away, but it's still going to go down as Krilly might be able to blink out, does so in time, but he is the only survivor of that onslaught of a team fight. And he can do, again, nothing to be able to stop Roshan going down. So, Team Dog, because they backed away early and let 4FC try and determine when the Rosh fight was going to happen, bought themselves a little bit of time for Pycat to farm up, and thanks to his ultimate, the power of a Spectre, able to find it. Oh, Krilly. He doesn't even survive. MSS catches him out with a tornado. MSS is doing so well right now. Roshan has Aegis now up on Pycat. It looks like he purchased up something. Did he? Oh, that's right. Sorry. I forgot the buyback. Middle tower is under attack. I was like, where did some of his gold go? Yeah, he bought back. So he's going to go back to farming. Now that he has the Aegis, you don't necessarily have to. I think when you're holding the Aegis, you can kind of consider going for even something like a Manta. You know, just a little bit of extra team fight damage if you want to, a little bit of extra pushing power, because you've got the Aegis to be able to fall back on. You don't necessarily need to be super, super tanky right now. They're controlling the game well. Juicy's going to lead with that weave. And that's pretty dangerous up against the flat cannon. You're already hitting every single hero, and every single hero is taking down less and less armor as the time goes on. That flat cannon can definitely do a lot of work right now. But it's going to be on cooldown for another 10 seconds. Ooh. Time is almost up. Will we see an MKB or full Divine coming out from 4FC? Carl Phillip is about to show us just another 200 gold for the MKB. Tornado EMP catching out Aris Loco, who has to make the jump forward. Now orchiding up MSS and leaping away. He's just trying to disable that big Invoker player and get his team out of the team fight. Ultimate's going to pop, though. They know. Aris Loco, Storm Bomb, they're both low. Spectre should be able to clean him up. Really trying to get away. There goes Spectre. All in right now as he's going to chase down Aris Loco. Juicy can do nothing to stop him. In fact, he's going to be the next victim. As Pycat now focuses on him, no Shallgrave up. And Pycat just grabs two easy kills. Even Gyrocopter going to go down as he tries to face up against Pycat. Triple kill. Dagger going to go down. Krilly dragging away Smogleek, but he does have the ultimate auto attack. Not quite enough. As Krilly pops a magic wand charges and Smogleek goes ahead and just teleports away with nothing to fear. And GG called. They lost the gold on Gyrocopter. He couldn't finish up his MKB, and he sure as hell is not going to get a Divine Rapier anytime soon. They know this is just not going to go their way, so they call the early GG call without even a Rax going down, knowing it's just sort of futile. So Team Dog take down two teams in a row real quickly, and they're going to enjoy coming back into the Gigabyte Challenge tomorrow, where they should be facing up against Team Virtus Pro. Now, we have to actually check the bracket. No, Virtus Pro. They either did not show up, they either forfeited their matchup, or lost. I'm not sure which, but it's a completely unknown team. Bratva Narika. I have no idea if I pronounced that correctly. They're from Kyrgyzstan. They're from Kyrgyzstan, and apparently they won up against Virtus Pro. So, interesting. I have no idea whether or not that was an actual win or forfeit. I'll check into it and get back to you guys. But Virtus Pro are out of this tournament, meaning Team Dog will have the opportunity to face up against the Kyrgyzstans. We'll call them that, because apparently Kyrgyzstan is easier to say than what their actual name is. It's either them or Commanda Minus is the other team, and they're from Bulgaria. So that game is going on right now. However, we're not going to be able to cast it. We're actually going to jump down to the lower bracket. And we're scheduled to move on in 40 minutes time. So we might have a slight break, but we're going to go ahead and follow TCN and their trial through the lower bracket. So TCN's facing up against Ubels, and the winner of that facing up against the winner of Goomba versus Dusa. Two more best of ones coming up, guys. But for now, short little commercial break. Music break, and I'll let you know exactly what the plan is, whether we're going to try and kick this off a little bit early or if we have to wait until 2030 to get the lower bracket started. Anyway, guys, stick around. Stay, just open up something in the other bracket. Listen to music, turn on, watch the commercials, that sort of jazz, and I'll let you guys know what's happening in just a few minutes.